Good day, everybody. Star here. What is going on? Playing on CP Obscure, the most hipster map ever, just based on the name of it. It makes me empowered. It makes me feel strong because you guys ain't heard of this. It's so obscure. But actually, it is kind of a popular map. It is a really good one. If you haven't played on it before, I would recommend it. Also, playing the Pyro class on it, using the entire power jack set, the gas jockey, so I run a little bit faster, take a little bit more damage from bullets, but that doesn't really come into play very much. Not very many bullets being shot at me, just a lot of rockets. I think they've actually got 4 to 5 soldiers on their team. It felt like 5. Probably wasn't that many, maybe 4, maybe 3, but a lot of soldiers constantly fighting me. 9 health right here, saved myself from that. And I get a lot of reflex in this gameplay because of the amount of soldiers. I was really consistent with them, but very consistent as well in not hitting the actual rockets on the reflect. I don't deal any damage from reflecting the rockets. I just miss every single time. Like, cool, I got the reflect, but no damage dealt with it, but that's okay. That's fine. You know, as a pyro, as long as you're able to reflect stuff and keep that damage off of yourself and your teammates, you know, it allows you to push just that much stronger. Your teammates aren't taking damage from it. They don't have to worry about it as much. There's kind of a good example coming up in a moment here when you actually finally start to push the second point up there, just trying to battle this scout a little bit. Forget about him, don't really care. I don't want to get to a battle with him. We've got more important things to do, like go capture the point. And here's the scout anyway, showing up behind him. He did. I don't use the shotgun as much as I really want it to in this gameplay. I was thinking of switching to the flare gun. I don't know why I never actually did. Just sort of didn't do that. So right here we come out here and there is a soldier up on top of this crate ready to shoot rockets at us. We take no damage from it and he doesn't really want to fire the second round. So you know, normally on that push we would have taken a lot of spam damage from him up on that slight high ground advantage. But, you know, even though I wasn't able to hit him with the reflect and deal that insane damage from the reflect, you know, we've still got, you know, a lot of advantage on that push because it sort of negates everything that soldier wanted to do. Like, cool, you can't shoot rockets at us. You kind of better back off, because I was on point with the reflex. I wasn't missing many of them. You know, had he shot the second one, I'm pretty sure I would have gotten rid of it. So, being a pyro, credit to team. I try and be really aggressive here and get in on the points. Unfortunately, they have a lot of soldiers. One behind me I didn't even notice, just sort of shows up there. Can't reflect them all, getting a little bit overwhelmed. Probably shouldn't have pushed in there by myself to begin with and stayed with the medic or with some of these guys, because you can see they're having some trouble getting in there right now, getting spammed out by rockets, but I could have reflected those. I could have been there. I could have been helping them. You know, it's not always the best thing to be aggressive and overextend and just get yourself killed. Would have been much better off, you know, chilling out, but, you know, it was a good attempt on my part anyway, trying to get behind them and hoping nobody would notice me. Unfortunately, they did, and this match goes into a slight stalemate here where we try and push this last point for quite a while. They show up into this room and just, you know, got a power jack and try and get that. Unfortunately, he killed himself, I believe, so don't get any health back from it. And yeah, that's what's going on right now. There are actually 3 matches of CP Obscure within this gameplay. It's not just this one. It might even be 4. I don't quite remember. I recorded these a while ago and set up this view. Well, I don't know. Now, all of that being said about Pyro, I don't really know what else to tell you. I've talked about it before, and Pyro is really a basic class. It has just a few couple principles which you just need to get used to, and I think you'll learn more from watching the gameplay than me trying to explain exactly what I'm doing, why I'm doing it, because it is really basic. It's just, you have the ability to zone people out. Even if you are in direct line of sight of somebody, a lot of the times people would rather avoid a pyro because they're so annoying to deal with at certain ranges where they can reflect your rockets, they can reflect your pipes, anything like that. You just kind of have to say, you know what, that pyro's over there. He's holding that area down. I'll find somewhere else to go. I don't care about him. And the only other thing pyro-related that I could possibly think to talk about is, oh my god, you guys! Is the pyro a boy or a girl or an alien or maybe a jukebox? I'm actually gonna go with the jukebox option. I really think the pyro probably is a jukebox, and I don't care enough that I'm gonna make a really legitimate opinion on this, so pyro's a jukebox. That seems legitimate to me. I don't really care. Quick fix going in here. Doing as much damage as possible. Don't have, you know, invulnerability, so I'm still a little bit scared about getting hit by these rockets. Don't have the extinguisher to deal insane damage. So I think it did pretty good work for, you know, how long we were in there, just letting people on fire, distraction. It went alright. Another thing I want to talk to you guys about is, if you didn't notice, Steam Workshop is looking for festive entries, items that are related to a holiday that rhymes with Smithmas. That is pretty cool, because I actually completely forgot about this, but the last Christmas holiday sort of December-y update was actually a really good update. There was a lot of new weapons in it, there was a lot of content to that one. They even gave people, you know, the festive keys to unlock crates, and some lucky bastards got unusuals out of that. How do you get unusual off of one key that you got for free? I'm jealous. Pretty jealous, but yeah. Yeah. So if you actually are one of the content creators and you are going to be making festive items for Team Fortress 2, or you ever wanted to make an item and try and get it in the game, now seems like a pretty legitimate chance. I mean, they actually did add a lot of the Halloween-themed items into the game pretty quickly there. I was really surprised to see that. And not too long after the Steam Workshop was set up, they took a lot of the most Halloween-themed things and just said, you know what, we're throwing them all in the game. You can only wear them once a month. But we're actually going to make the game so glitchy and buggy that you can wear them pretty much all the time, whatever you want. Which seems to be the case right now. I don't really know what's up with that. But I just wanted to mention that. It's pretty cool, so there probably will be a pretty big update for the Christmases times, the holiday times. If you are a content creator, please spend your time making weapons rather than hats. That would be awesome. I would much rather see weapons in the game, and if they have more weapons to choose from, there probably will be more weapons. And I will, you know, whenever there is an update, I try and get all of the weapons up on my channel, gameplays of them as soon as possible, so look forward to that from me. I always try really hard to get them up here, like, as soon as that update hits. Hats and stuff, you know, when there's an update with a whole bunch of hats, I tend to barely mention it. I don't really care about much of that stuff anymore. So, that's just me, though. If you must make a hat, because let's be honest, hats probably have a higher chance of getting in the game than any weapons do, because they actually have to, like, make stats for the weapons. Here's what you gotta make. To feed my ego, you know these stars that go on the top of Christmas trees? Yes, you will make that as a hat. It'll go on people's heads, and it will honor me, so that my ego will be fed at all times. And the description of the item will be, Star is awesome, and the name of the item will be, Star is awesome. And I'll be like, yes, thank you, obviously, thank you, someone finally realized. I'm not being entirely serious, but at the same time, that would be pretty cool. And as far as Christmas-themed hat goes, it fits the theme perfectly. It goes on top of the Christmas tree. It goes on your head. Pyro would wear that. Pyro wears bird cages. Dumbo, jukeboxes don't know what hats are. A lot of people are probably going to ask what other Christmas theme stuff I'd want to see, and I really don't care. Like, you know, the themes of stuff, I don't care that much. I'm really, really, really stopping caring about hats in this game altogether. Right? I just want to, like, get rid of mine and be like, you know, whatever. Hats, I am beyond you, hats. I am way better than you. I don't need you anymore. I cannot believe I survived through this right here. Air blasted that heavy away, killed that scout at the last second, and actually getting away from that. But yeah, as long as a weapon gets in the game that's actually, like, cool and usable, it doesn't even have to be the greatest weapon ever, as long as it's something new and interesting and, you know, looks decent, then I'm happy with that. I don't really care what it is otherwise. Maybe, I don't even know, just, there's some items that I think we've all wanted to see for quite a while, where, like, a new SMG for the sniper, I would like to see that, I really would. Also, a different type of huntsman for the sniper would be pretty cool. And just in general, the types of items I want to see aren't anything in particular, it's just... I would like to see new items for the stuff that haven't really gotten that many different versions of, like the Huntsman, or the SMG, or the pistols don't have a lot of different versions, and the Winger, let's be honest, the Winger, they really should have done something different with that. I'm really disappointed with the direction they took on that pistol. They probably aren't all that interested in giving new pistols to begin with, it seems like, because not many of them have been accepted, and the Winger that has been accepted, just, what does it do? Barely anything. It's kind of unfortunate. Rushing in here to getting on the point, hopefully, maybe, air blasting everything at them, trying to escape. You can see how much damage I reflected back at them. And then we finally win the match. Everyone gets in there right after that. My name this entire video, by the way, has been Fart. It has not been Star, so if you missed that, you haven't been paying attention to the kill icon things at the top right. My name has been Fart. I don't even know why. I don't know. Fart. But yeah, anyway, I'm really looking forward to that update and everything I mentioned there. It just feels like I'm at that point right now with Team Fortress 2 where I really want some new toys to play around with. Just some new items to say, you know, this is cool and fun and new. Let me mess around with this for quite a while like I have been with the Market Gardener. And find a new love in a new weapon. Aw, so sweet. But this is the last match right here. Kind of an uneventful match, and I say uneventful more so just because I don't even get to see the last point being captured. It just sort of happens and gets back capped a little bit. I'm nowhere near it when it happens, but still a pretty solid round here as Pyro just going around spy check and making sure no one's doing anything scandalous while I'm not around. Making sure the point gets captured and all that good stuff. I hope you guys are looking forward to the update. You can talk about that in the comment section, what items you might be looking forward to. It might even give some people some ideas on what they might be making, because I was even just taking a look at the Steam Workshop a moment ago. There is still some really, really good stuff on there that just looking at it still makes me like imagine and wonder, what would it be like if this was actually in the game? It deserves to be, because it looks phenomenal. And I know it would be awesome. Unless they gave it stats like the Family Business, where it's pretty much just like a cop-out. Like, oh, this is a shotgun, but it's still a shotgun. It's pretty much a shotgun. Kind of unfortunate the way some items go in that regard. But hope you guys enjoyed this video. Press the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. I posted lots of Team Fortress 2 content, and that's really all I got for you now, because the round suddenly ends right now, and that is it. So, peace out, everyone. Hope you enjoyed this. Medic. I love the way he topples over. And I taunt over his flaming corpse. Peace out.